Very good afternoon, students. Regarding economic biology, today we are going to discuss about mushroom and its cultivation. So, what is a mushroom? A mushroom or toadstool is a fleshy, spore-bearing fruiting body of a fungus. Typically produced above ground on soil or on its food source. Mushroom is a fungi belonging to Basidiomycetes. All types of edible mushrooms contain varying degrees of protein and fiber. They also contain vitamin B as well as a powerful antioxidant called selenium, which helps to support the immune system and prevent damage to cells and tissues. There are more than 3000 types of mushrooms. Example, button mushroom, it is called as Agaricus bisporus. This is oyster mushroom. It is known as Pleurotus species. Cholesterol free, low sodium, low calorie, fat free. Contain several polysaccharides, though more research is needed. See calories, 28 calories, fat, protein, carbohydrate, fiber. So this is the nutritive value of oyster mushroom, Pleurotus. Next, paddy straw mushroom. It is known as Valveriella valvaceae, paddy straw mushroom. So these are all the different types of mushroom. Let me pass on what is mushroom cultivation. Mushroom cultivation is a technology of growing mushroom using plant, animal and industrial waste. In short, it is wealth out of waste technology. This technology has gained importance worldwide because of its dietary fibers, vitamins and minerals. Mushroom cultivation is one of the most profitable agricultural business that can start with a low investment and less space. The cultivation takes 1 to 3 months. Let me discuss the major stages of mushroom cultivation. So, what are the major stages of mushroom cultivation? Composting, spawning, casing, pinning, harvesting, at last it should be preservation. So these are all the major stages of mushroom cultivation. Let me see each stage in detail. The very first stage is composting. What do you mean by compost? Compost is prepared by mixing paddy straw with number of organic material like cow dung and inorganic fertilizer. For synthetic compost, preferably wheat or rice straw is used. It is kept at about 50 degrees Celsius for 1 week. So, mushroom compost. What is the need of compost? A commercially produced compost provides nutrients needed for mushroom to grow, serving as a base for growing mushroom. In mushroom production, composting is a basic process that prepares nutritional materials for the growth of mushroom. So, composting, it is very important process that prepare nutritional material for the growth of mushroom. This is the first stage. of mushroom cultivation. The second stage of mushroom cultivation is spawning. Spawn is the mushroom seed. Mushroom spawn is the mycelium growing on a given substrate. It serves as a seed or planting material in mushroom cultivation. Spawning is the inoculation of the culture into the substrate or compost. It is the actual planting of spawn and requires much care depending on the species of mushroom. So what is a spawn? Spawn is a mushroom seed. It is prepared by growing fungal mycelium in grains under sterile conditions. Spawn is sown on compost. So this is the second stage of mushroom cultivation. Next, third stage of mushroom cultivation, casing. Compost is covered with a thin layer of soil. It gives support to the growing mushroom, provides humidity, and helps to regulate the temperature. Mushroom casing is the last layer of media in commercial mushroom growth. Peat is used as it will hold 10 times its own weight in moisture, and mushrooms thrive in this environment. Casing is a natural environment for mushroom to grow in. So this is the third stage of mushroom cultivation, casing. So casing preparation, it involves three steps: casing mixture preparation, sterilization, and layering. Why casing is required? Casing is helped to convert vegetative growth into mushroom. If casing is not done, then there is no formation of mushroom. If there is some growth of mushroom, then it is very less. Casing also helps to maintain proper moisture condition in the compost. What are the materials needed for casing mixture preparation? Vermiculture, compost or manure, hand spray bottle, growing chamber with oven, Lysol and peroxide used for controlling green mold growth, water for spraying, fully grown fungal mycelial substrate jar. Quality of the casing material. So soft in texture, lightweight, high water holding capacity, high porosity, efficient in available form of carbon and nitrogen, neutral pH, it is 7 to 7.5, low conductivity. So these are all the quality of casing material. So what is casing? Compost is covered with a thin layer of soil that only provides support to the growing mushroom, and it also provides humidity and helps to regulate the temperature. So next stage of mushroom cultivation is pinning. So what is mushroom pinning? It is the trickiest part for a mushroom grower, since a combination of carbon dioxide concentration, temperature, light and humidity triggers mushrooms towards fruiting. Mycelium starts to form little bud, which will develop into mushroom. Those little white buds are called pins. So this is one of the important stage of mushroom cultivation, that is pinning. Next stage, harvesting. Mushroom grow better in 15 degrees Celsius to 23 degrees Celsius. They grow in 3 centimeter in a week, which is the normal size for harvesting. In the third week, the first flush mushroom can be harvested. The process takes 4 to 6 weeks, depends on the raw material and the system used at the compost yard. So this is about the harvesting method. So far we discussed different stages of mushroom cultivation. First stage, composting, next spawning, then casing, then pinning, at last harvesting. Now preservation. Discoloration, weight and flavor loss are the main problems during harvesting of mushroom. So mushroom should be preserved through various method. So what are the principles of preservation? Removal of water, heat sterilization, lowering of temperature, providing chemical environment, sterilization with ionizing radiation. These are all the principles of preservation. So what are the different methods of preservation of mushroom? Freezing, drying, canning, vacuum cooling, gamma radiation, and storing at 15 degrees Celsius. So these are all the different methods are used to increase the life of mushroom. Let me see the preservation methods in detail. First, freezing method. To freeze the mushrooms raw, trim their stems and place them in a freezer. Safe plastic bag, squeeze out as much air before sealing the bag and placing it in freezer. So through this way, mushroom can be preserved. Next method is drying method. Drying mushroom is a wonderful way to preserve them for long-term storage. Drying mushroom with your food dehydrator is an easy method. Drying done by using oven, using the sun is another way of drying mushroom. Next method is canning. In this method, mushrooms are washed, then cut the stalk and pack into quarter or half liter jars, leave 3 cm head space. So this is the canning method to preserve mushroom. Next method is vacuum cooling. Mushrooms are perfectly suited for vacuum cooling. Vacuum cooled mushrooms are significantly better with regard to color than conventionally cooled. It's a rapid cooling method for mushroom. Another method is gamma radiation. It affects on shelf life, texture, polyphenol oxidase and microflora of mushroom. So these are all the preservation methods of mushroom. So far we discussed what is mushroom, what is mushroom cultivation, what are the stages involved in mushroom cultivation, and how to preserve harvested mushroom for a long term. That's all about today's class. Thank you.